right now. Change your mind. The wife came. They came to serve God. Can I tell the truth? The land belongs to them. It was their property. Anything you own, you're not the owner. You are a caretaker. God is the original owner. He pleases him to give it to you. Are you sure you're listening to me? Don't think you make money by your strength. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 18. And thou shalt remember that it is the Lord thy God that gave you power. So if God doesn't give you power, you will struggle and die. One thing I learned in my life is to give. I don't go to church and go back. My sons are there. I don't go to a church and go back home with money. I empty myself. Even if I hold 1 million there, I will finish it. I don't carry money to church and carry money back. Except after service, somebody sows it for me. I don't do that. Sir, if you must be mighty, there are price to pay for you to be great. The woman was an era of scarcity. Everything was done with her. She has nothing in her. She has no money in her bank account. So she has concluded within herself that let this little food in her, that she will eat it with her son and then wait for death to come. That means they conclude about themselves that their era is gone, that they will die after that moment. But unknown to them that God has planned for them. Sir, every Thanksgiving is organized because of somebody. Thanksgiving is not organized for everybody. It's been organized for one person. God allowed Elijah to make the pronunciation for the sake of the widow of Zarephath. She has been going through pain. She has been going through struggle. At this time, the widow of Zarephath, she needs help. Elijah does not need help. If Elijah has the power to command the rain to stop, he also has the power to command food to appear. If he has the power to stop the sun not to shine, he also has the power to command ember to appear. At that spot, the widow need help, and God need to send a man to help the widow, because she has concluded within herself that nothing good about life anymore, because the Bible calls her widow. She has lost her husband before, and people sympathize with her. And now it's not a season of hunger. Every night or day she eat from hand to mouth. Every night or day she beg to eat her. At this time she said to her son, let's gather little stick at the entrance of the city, the little food that we have, let's eat it and die. While the power was dancing to take a lot, Jehovah saw the woman from heaven, and God conclude within himself, woman, you shall not die. But the woman was not aware. They came between God and Elijah. God spoke to Elijah. Go to Zarephath. I prepare a widow right there to take care of you. What amazed me is this. God never spoke to the widow, but God spoke to his servant. There are some of you look like dinner. You are waiting to hear a voice before you will do what you need to do to change your life. There are some of you looking at me now. You are saying to yourself, God has not talked to me to buy window. God has not talked to me to put AC in the church. God has not talked to me to buy car for the pastor. God has not talked to me to do something in the house of God. You are waiting to hear a voice. Sometimes God will not speak to you, but rather God will come in a massive way through the server and declare a word to the atmosphere. It takes a wise man, a wise woman, a wise boy, and a wise girl to understand the saying of Jehovah and to grab what God is saying to him or her. That was the case of the woman. The Bible said, and Elijah left where they broke her, and he back on the journey to Zarephath. As soon as he entered the city of Zidon, as soon as she appeared, God God enter the woman. Woman, you shall not die. Your error will not end. Your husband died in struggle. Your husband died in beggar. Your husband died without building a house. You also want to die in that manner. Woman, you will not die. God enter the woman and push the woman to where she will meet with Elijah. There are some of you God brought you here today so you can meet with me, for your story to change, for you to enter another level. And as soon as Elijah entered Zidon, God spoke to Elijah, lift up your eyes, lift up your head, behold the woman coming. And Elijah ran to the woman, because power is about to change her, because season is about to change her, and all is about to end. A new season of abundance is about to begin, it's about to start. And so God spoke to him. Elijah went straight to the woman. He said, mother, you are looking wonderful. He said, mother, you are looking gorgeous. After praising the woman, the reason why she was praising the woman, I guess, listen, what are the thoughts of the Bible? Not that I say praise the woman, though. I'm using my own understanding, so don't misquote me. So, and as soon as he was trying to praise the woman, so that the woman can release the food, sir, when it comes to the business of the kingdom, you don't please men to be blessed. When they come to the kingdom of the business of the kingdom, you don't beg men. When they come to the business of the kingdom, you don't force men. Destiny is by her. The salvation is personal. And the Bible said Elijah called the woman. He said, mother, please, I am thirsting for water. One thing I understand that is easy to give is water, because water is easy to find. So he said to the widow, he said, my priest, I'm thirsty, give me water. And the woman said, sir, I will give you water. She was going to collect the water when Elijah said, mother, please excuse me, come back. And as soon as the woman come back, Elijah said to the woman, mother, I'm not just thirsty alone, I am hungry, give me food. Sir, Elijah wasn't hungry, because God provided the raven to give him food. That raven was still in the hand of God. God provided the broker to take care of Elijah. So Elijah wasn't tested. God sent Elijah to Zidon because of the widow. God sent me to this program because of somebody. You will not miss your opportunity today. If you shall tell me, my God, answer you.
Hey, say, mother, food. The woman said, I don't have food, though. I got no food to eat. Can I tell the truth? We only have small oil and small yam. We have small oil and small yam. What you see me doing here now, the Lord just spoke to me now. There's somebody in this service, you have nothing. You even came to this Thanksgiving because you think, make you not just come, now make you come. But the Lord is saying to me that your story will change today. I'm talking to one person. The person knows himself. One person. You start to come. But today, the reason why God brought you, there's an anointing to change your story. The woman says, I don't have food, though. That food where your eye takes, so now me and my son get her. If we eat finish, we are waiting for the death that killed the husband to come and take his life and the life of the husband. I mean, the woman herself. Take her life and the son. So, Elijah said, woman, you will not die. First of all, give me to eat first. Can I talk to you? In Matthew 17, 25, Jesus asked Peter, to whom the sons of men? Peter's. And he said to Caesar, he said, for we not to offend them, go to the river, throw thy net, the hook, you will catch fish. When you catch the fish, open his mouth, you will see coin inside. Pay for me first. For me where? First. And after they pay for thyself. So that means God first. So for the woman's story to change, he has to touch God first. I used to tell my children in the church, if what you have in your hand cannot meet your need, sow it out. What did I say? Sow it out. You are planning to buy land. You have gathered 500,000. And the land is 2 million. And you are struggling to gather. You don't need to struggle. Sow out the 500,000. Give it out. When you give it out, you won't struggle for the 2 million to come. Because if what you have cannot solve your problem, give it out. So that the one that can solve your problem, let him solve your problem. Are you sure? Listen to me. The poorest church in this world are prayer church. Are churches that pray, die, fire, die. Shiloh just ended. I was there. All the days I was there. Put your hand on your ear. Say, Father, any foundation that want to speak to me, not to obey your voice, let the foundation be perished. My spirit, you will not hear the voice of that foundation. In the name of Jesus. It was the foundation that killed the husband that spoke to the woman. He said, we don't have food in the house. Now, small thing. Elijah knows it's not small thing you get. Because God has already told Elijah everything that is happening in your house. He knows the secret. Elijah said, give me first. Reluctantly, she went. She brought the food. And as soon as he ate the food, Elijah said to the woman, for the years that this rain will not fall, you will be the one to feed the whole nation. Can I tell you the truth? Read your Bible. Go down. That same 17, go down. Two things happen. After he finished feeding the man of God, the foundation that killed the husband came to kill the child. The power that killed the father killed the son. In other words, God saw death coming on the way of the one because she said, we will eat and die. Some of you have already concluded that if this year not favor you, 2023, you will kill yourself. You will not kill yourself, man. You will not kill yourself, sir. Hear me, well. 2023 is your year. Let me change your mindset. All those of you that are saying, now Peter B, now God, now I want to change this country. Don't be Peter B, change your mind. What did I say? Change your mind. Because the Peter B you are seeing is a man, and any man can change at any given time. David said that, look unto the hill. Hence come at my help. My help is not Peter B. My help is not Buhari. My help is not nobody. My help cometh from Jehovah. Are you trying to listen to me? So change your mind. There are some of you have gathered. You have gathered everything. You tied this one at the keeper. Because we don't know what happened in 2023. Faithless people. You are trying to eat it and wait for death. Don't eat it and wait for death. Let it go. And the woman let it go. The first miracle God did is stop the covenant of sudden death in that family. The second miracle that God did became the woman have more than enough. A woman that said I have nothing, she have more than enough. The Bible says she began to give excessively to people. She have more than enough. After this thanksgiving, you will have more than enough. In the name of Jesus. Listen to this. Listen to this. Before our thanksgiving, somebody came to me and gave me a seed. Big money. He said, man of God, please take. The man of God, the person gave me 100,000. He said that he used this 100,000 to buy shoe that you will use for the thanksgiving. I said, no problem. I was in the church. My son is there. You can bear me witness. I was in the church when somebody called me. They said, man of God, please. They want to operate him. And the operation will cost 1.30 million. I said, sir, I don't have that such money. What I have right now is just 100,000. And I said, but I will send you 80,000. Instantly from the church, I gave him 80,000. That was the only money in my account at that time. As soon as I gave the 80,000, another call came in again. Sir, we have no food in the house. And I said, what do you want? Say, sir, anything you can give. I gave 10,000. I said, use it to manage yourself. As soon as I finished that one, that call came. I said, and now temptation. I gave her the 100,000. After that day, the night that somebody came and gave me money, about 30,000. I went to the church. I put the money in my pocket. So I went to the church, and my father's church, and we were just there. No, as the man was preaching, something entered me. I began to give the money. So I gave the money until I didn't know I finished my money. So when we closed, somebody came to me and said, sir, so money, give it to me. I said, actually, I bring the money to give you before. It's like I don't show and finish as a seed. The person asked me, say, sir, you know they change money for church? I sound bigger than that. How can I go to the house of God and change money? For the father who is giving me the money, it's not God. So I can't change money in the house of God. I left. 3 days interval. The God of divine supply appeared. And double what I gave, times three, and gave it to me. Can I tell you the truth? If what you have cannot solve your problem, why holding it? Why holding it? She know that this food will not solve her problem. So let her eat and die. I was believing God for a land that we want to use for something. And I've been praying for that land. God, give me this land, give me this land, give me this land. And the land was not coming. And I was in the church, God spoke to me. All the money you have, since the money cannot buy the land, why don't you give the money out? So I called myself. I wasn't gonna call you all. You called me. Huh? I told you. Okay, I called you. I told you. One of my small boys was supposed to come with me. One of my small boys in the church. He entered my wife's office. They were praying. As they were praying, the boy ran to me. He said, Daddy, I heard a voice. I heard a voice. I said, what is the voice? He said, I heard the voice. I said, you are looking for money for land, and you don't have money for the land. He said, the God said, the money that you have now, go and give it, as if the money cannot give you the land. I said, you hear God well. Meanwhile, God don't tell sins that they struggle until God spoke to the boy. A week to the Thanksgiving, I went to the bank. Sir, I'm not telling you small money. I'm not telling you change. I'm not telling you change. I'm telling you money is enough for someone to start good business. I went to the bank. I withdraw everything from the bank. There was one money I was gathering to use for something. Sir, when I called the person, the money, I said, bring that money to, when they brought the money, they sell a fee when the money they reach like this. I add everything. I sat on the altar. I look at the money. A voice came to me. You mean you want to carry this money out? When I heard that voice, I delay again. I'm telling the truth as a pastor. I gathered the money, took courage. I called my father and the Lord. I said, Papa, I'm coming tomorrow. I want to come and see you. I bought a big envelope, those brown envelope, the big one. I put the money inside. And I went to, I said, Papa, I am looking for a particular land. This is all I've gathered. He can't give me the land. So I'm giving it to you. Just, I need only one thing from your mouth. Just pronounce. Take the land. And the man smiled. He said, you get sense. So you're a white child. He said, my son, go, the land is yours already. I said, amen. On our Thanksgiving day, one of my sons came. He told me the secret. He said that land where you are defined, so I will buy it for you. I said, no problem. So I called her. I said, hold the mic. And he held the mic. And he said, I'm giving you so million. Everybody shouted. They didn't know they see their soul. There's secret behind that. One pastor called me and said, man of God, say, I have money, they fly for your head. He did not know the secret. I don't want to waste your time. Don't be the foolish among the foolish. Sir, the reason you came here is for life transformation. For what? Life transformation. It was in Shiloh. Do you know what they call Shiloh? It was in Shiloh that the life of Sarah, Hannah, was transformed. How they did transform? It was a sacrifice they gave that opened a heaven. This is a Thanksgiving day. There is a door that is open for you, but you cannot access it until that which is your hand is out of your hand. They are here. One thing I can never lack in my life, I've said it before, is money. Sir, what did I say? What did I say? My church, if you go to my church, they will tell you. One thing I can't lack in my life is what? It's money. As I'm preaching, I lack the enter my phone. That's how it works. You know why? When you are, your heart is for the kingdom service. When your heart is for the kingdom eye will feast on you. The eyes of Jehovah will be feast on you. In Acts chapter 20, verse 2.
Lord, I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle Christian. Lord, I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle Christian. Lord, I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle Christian.
Someone like David, someone like Elijah, who prayed fire down. God is looking for someone like Susanna Wesley, someone like Elijah, who prayed fire down. God is looking for someone like David Brainerd, someone like Elijah, who prayed fire down. A sick man standing and a prayer warrior, that's sure for miracle.
Lord, I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle Christian. Lord, I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle man. I want to be a miracle Christian.
Someone like Elijah, who bring fire down. God is looking for someone like Charles Finney. Someone like Elijah, who bring fire down. God is looking for someone like Father Nash. Someone like Elijah, who bring fire down.
Deliverance Ministry. Holiness is our way. a place where you can encounter God in person. Are you seeing? Are you blind? Are you blind or you are in need? Jesus. Every Wednesday is our deliverance and counseling service. Time is 8 a.m. in the morning. Every Sunday is our prophetic and deliverance service. Time is 8 a.m. in the morning. Every last Friday of the month is our praise night. Time is 10 p.m. till dawn. Every first Sunday of the month is our morning service. Time is 8 a.m. in the morning. Fellowship with us at number 1 of 23 of Ibunaduwa Street, Odida, Benue City. Telephone 07061 34 31. You can follow us on YouTube channel at CTDM Overcomers TV to get all our messages. Visit us and follow us on Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, Instagram, app, email, email, speak of our famous